The Education and Sports Committee residential retreat that was organized at Serena Hotel in Chigo almost went out of order on the opening day as MPs threatened to walk out in protest due to absence of the line ministers. Legislators contended that the line ministry was taking them for granted.
When we don't see the National Council of Sports and many others, Chair, it gives for me a very big heart pain as to why we are here. The ministers who are aware that we are supposed to be here, Chair, it is total abuse of the committee. In fact, if I had the authority, I would just say that we stop here. We don't have this retreat because it is total abuse of the committee.
After here, I would request that on behalf of the members, go and call one of the ministers to be here. Because it's as if it's a small matter. It's a very big matter which must have been attended by everybody. That these ones are just implementers, but our policy makers are not here. So let's get any statement from them. Because for you, for the peers to find out where they are, it is you actually, Mr. Chairman. Go and find out.
If you can tell us that today they cannot attend, this is a clear sign either they are sleeping on the job or they are intentionally tired of work. They don't want to work with us. It has been a common practice. Ministers from education have been dodging this committee. And they are in there just useless. And to them, maybe we do not matter. They feel they can do whatever they can. And it's evident, Honorable Chair, so many things have been moving on from the ministry. And they go ahead and start implementing without consulting members of parliament.
Honorable Kupekitira is one of the polished Basoga leaders. I therefore have information that President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni is not lacking people to appoint as ministers. We have person number one in the name of you, Chair, who is chairing. Person number two, Honorable Kupekitira, so that we will sit on the backbench and push the policy.
Lawmakers argued that critical issues affecting the sector were not on the agenda of the three-day meeting, wondering whether the engagement will live up to the billing.
When you look at these documents, and you know me, I'm good at reading, the documents they have given us, including the presentation, which is going to be made by the PS, it's not signed, it's not owned. These other documents from NCDC, the same, nobody has put a signature, all of them. So somebody will say, whatever you have discussed, I'm not part because I cannot own this.
The scope of what you people have defined here does not address these silent issues.
So
you need to, before you suspend, make sure the PS organizes her team so that we're able to find answers to all these problems.
John Twesije, the chairperson of the committee, was forced to suspend the meeting for 15 minutes to make consultations.
We shall need answers. So let us, members, as a
we
suspend,
need to
we come
urgent,
back.
Urgent and important.
Let us suspend
because
the meeting.
We may be handling things that are not important.
We come urgent. Back at midday.
The committee was later able to resume business after receiving communication that one minister will be present tomorrow. Katie Lamaro, the permanent secretary, submitted to MPs calling for support of the ministry in the quest for 24 billion shillings to pay suppliers of materials needed by schools to roll out the new curriculum.
The available budget is not sufficient to address the current obligations with suppliers. Our ministry has submitted a request to the Ministry of Finance. This is really with regard to instructional materials for lower secondary. And the ministry has engaged with the Ministry of Finance for additional resources, and they have responded really to confirm that they will provide this budget for us, and we are grateful to finance for that.
The three-day retreat is expected to rotate around technical and vocational education and training, the national teacher policy, special needs and inclusive education policy, implementation of the new curriculum, among others. It's expected to climax on Thursday with an interface with the Minister of Education and Sports, Janet Kataha Museveni. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.